Being an environmentally and culturally responsible traveler can be hard. Whether you're planning a safari to see lions and giraffes in the African savannas, or a snorkeling adventure over brilliantly colored coral reefs in Southeast Asia, there are several questions to grapple with. Which hotel do you pick? Which tour operator do you go with? What sites do you see? Who benefits from your travel? In the 1970s and 80s, people thinking about these issues came up with a solution: ecotourism. Ecotourism is the idea that in some places, tourism can be specifically designed to support the conservation of biodiversity and the well-being of the local communities. That is, you can enjoy your travel and be good to both the planet and its people at the same time. In theory, ecotourism sounds like a win-win solution. How it plays out in the real world, though, is not as straightforward. On the positive side, there are examples of ecotourism ventures that have fulfilled their pledges to support conservation and culture. Ecotourism has brought in much-needed funding to manage protected areas with threatened or rare species. For example, the management of Windi National Park in Uganda depends heavily on revenue from gorilla viewing ecotourism. Ecotourism endeavors have also provided alternate livelihood options to nearby communities. This has prompted them to move away from destructive forest practices like agriculture, logging, or hunting, and invest more in keeping the local wildlife and natural areas intact. In Madagascar's Ania Community Reserve, for example, ecotourism revenue has supported jobs and paid for community projects like public schools. This in turn has encouraged the local people to replant native trees on hillsides surrounding the reserve. At the same time, the reserve's lemur population increased from 80 in the early 2000s to roughly 350 now. In some cases, ecotourism has contributed to instilling a sense of pride among the local communities for their wildlife and heritage. And this, in part, has inspired them to set aside some of their own land to protect biodiversity and habitats. On the flip side, a 2018 review of existing scientific papers pointed out that several ecotourism projects have led to deforestation. Too many tourists can create high demand for timber to build lodges and hotels. Immigrants can move in for the new tourism opportunities, increasing demand for forest products. And patches of forests can get cleared to grow more crops to meet the growing demand for food. High tourist numbers can also put pressure on wildlife. Studies suggest that cheetahs, for example, sometimes abandon their kills when there are too many tourists around and fewer of their cubs survive. In one study, researchers saw 64 vehicles zoom in to watch a mother and her cubs over a period of just 2 hours. Power dynamics within communities can also mean that ecotourism benefits don't get distributed equitably. Richer people may profit more than those who are poor, or men may benefit more than women. In fact, studies suggest that ecotourism ventures that don't achieve their sustainability goals have a few things in common. They try to accommodate too many tourists, stressing the environment. They don't include the local communities sufficiently in all stages of the project. They don't generate enough revenue for the local people to see value in conservation compared to more destructive uses of the land. They often lack charismatic species or an accessible location to attract enough tourists, or they don't market their venture well enough. When ecotourism succeeds and becomes the primary support for conservation, that can be a problem too. Tourist flow can change due to political instability, weather, unsatisfactory wildlife sightings, or even disease outbreaks like the COVID-19 pandemic. And disappearing tourism revenue can trigger poaching or deforestation and make conservation less valuable for the local communities and governments. So the next time you see a tour operator or hotel selling ecotourism, ask questions, do your research. What is the venture doing to be environmentally friendly? Who runs the company? How are the local communities involved? The more answers you get, the more informed a choice you can make.